Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. So today's video is going to be a drugstore makeup haul. This is honestly random goodies, just random things I've picked up. Yeah, it's not like a collective haul. I guess you could say it was a collective haul. I definitely didn't buy this stuff all in one run, but it's just stuff I pick up here and there, things that intrigue me, things I want to try out, things I've heard that are good. So let's go ahead and get started. So first two things that are on top that I want to go ahead and get out of the way and want to talk about are, and I want some opinions on it, honestly. These are some like facial wipes. I went on a kick a while ago with these and I got them at TJ Maxx. I don't know how good like wipes are from like TJ Maxx and Marshalls. So I want y'all's opinion if you've ever tried wipes from there. These are the New Age Beauty Vitamin C Cleansing Cloths. And these are the Petal Fresh Botanicals Clarifying Facial Wipes with Tea Tree and Peppermint. Just give me an opinion on them. Do they irritate your skin? How do they, you know, if there's any actual benefits from them? I may use them just to remove swatches and stuff like that. They really honestly irritate my skin too much to even try to use them. But they look promising, especially the collagen vitamin C ones. I was really interested with these. And they were both only $3.99. So they intrigued me for that purpose, but I don't want to, I'm scared to try them because I don't want to break out my skin or, you know, piss off my skin, honestly, make it, you know, get a pimple or something. I definitely don't want to do that. So just let me know what you think down below or if you ever tried them or had an experience. Next thing right here is the Wet n Wild Brow and Lash Mascara. I got this just because it's Wet n Wild. It's brow mascara. I figured, hey, we could give this a shot. Pixi makes a clear one just like this. And to be completely honest, I don't really care for it. So I was really curious about this one because it's, I mean, it's Wet n Wild. It's obviously very affordable. It says you can use it for your lashes and also your eyebrows. I don't know the point of using it on your eyelashes. It says it's crystal clear, contains a punch of soy protein and vitamin E, and protect and condition your lashes. So maybe like an eyelash primer they were going with this before you put on your mascara, but I definitely bought this just to strictly use on my eyebrows. So I will update you guys on this. I may use it in like a full face first impressions or testing out new makeup videos. Those are like my favorite videos ever to film. But yeah, like I said, don't really care for the Pixi ones. We'll have to see. Next, this is extremely old. It's definitely not new. This is the CoverGirl Clean Liquid Foundation, and this is in 110 Classic Ivory. This is very old. I don't hear anybody talking about this, and that's why I wanted to get up. I just wanted to have more foundations in my collection. It says this is not designed for normal skin, natural lightweight coverage that feels and looks fresh, water-based, won't clog pores. And that's like basically it. There's really no other claims. I do have it in 110 Classic Ivory. It's glass packaging. It's a pour out style like the Maybelline Fit Me or the Dewy one. So there wasn't really a reason. I just picked it up because I wanted to try it out. Next thing we have right here is the L'Oreal Brow Stylist Definer in 388 Blonde. If you watch any of my videos, and especially videos that I do, you know, chit chat, get ready with me, they're just tutorials. I am a pomade girl. I absolutely adore pomade. I am wearing the Makeup Revolution pomade eyebrows right now. They just got reshaped and they're like, they're doing good. My eyebrows are on fleek right now because they're looking good. Anyways, I thought I should try a pencil. I don't know why, but I figured I could try a pencil. I don't really use pencils, like I said. Occasionally I will, but normally I do not. And I wanted to try this because supposedly this is a really good dupe for the Anastasia Brow Pencil or Brow Wiz. And it's got a really fine tip. It has a spoolie on the other end, so I figured I could just try it and see. See what happens. Maybe it'll change my life. Maybe I'll use a pencil and a pomade, but I'm pretty committed to pomades, so I don't really see it changing anytime soon. Next, I have the Ardell Pro Brow Building Fiber Gel. I saw this at HEB and I was like, this is on clearance for a dollar. And I was like, oh, I have to get it now at the dollar. Well, I didn't even know that they sold Ardell like brow things at my HEB, and I'm assuming it's on clearance because they're not selling it anymore. I currently don't see it in my HEB anymore, but this is a fiber brow gel in taupe. So it's more like the Gimme Brow and the Essence brow gel. It has that fiber and also tint to it, so it appears your brow hairs to be a lot fuller and a lot darker and deeper than what they obviously normally are. I thought this was cool. Literally, I got it because it was a dollar. Figured I could try it out. And yeah, when I got my eyebrows done this past week, the girl who does my eyebrows, I absolutely love her. She does such a good job. And I do get them done at Ulta at the Benefit Brow Bar. And she used the Benefit Gimme Brow. And I was like, oh God, she's going to use that. And she used it and then put it on. And I was like, oh, my eyebrows look so good. And I was like, I always tell myself, like, I'm not going to buy that. I have so many brow gels. I have my Essence one that is basically a dupe for that. And I was like, I'm not buying it. And she used it. And I was like, oh, it looks so good. Do I need it? And I'm sitting there thinking about it, contemplating it. And I'm very proud of myself because I walked out of there without it. And I'm going to try my very hardest now to never buy it because I just can't justify it. It's just, I'm just that type of person that can't justify it. So I got a good old dollar one that hopefully will do the trick. I got some lashes right here. These are the Salon Perfect Go Glam 614 lashes. These are really, really long, really, really wispy. They're also extremely affordable and from Walmart. I believe these are like $2 or $3 a pair. Love these. I highly recommend if you are a beginner. The band is extremely flexible. It is like a more transparent band, really easy to work with. So absolutely enjoy these. I just love how long and wispy they are. They make your eye makeup look amazing, and they have a little sticker on it that says blogger favorite, so I'm assuming they've been talked about a lot, but I really, really like those. And I have some goodies from Wet n Wild. I don't know how many more Wet n Wild things are in here, but this is the Wet n Wild gel lip liner in Think Flamingo. I love these gel lip liners. I definitely want to get the whole line. They're affordable, they're creamy, they're easy to apply. I'm not one to mess with lip liners. I'm not wearing a lip liner right now, to be completely honest. I think lip liners are a waste of money in some cases. Now, some lipsticks I have bought matching lip liners for because they need them. They run outside my lips. They just look better with a lip liner sometimes. And I feel like these Wet n Wild ones, I can justify buying them because I think they're around $2 a piece. They're gel, they're easy to apply, they're easy to get off. And I don't know, I feel better applying these than, you know, like a pencil one, or I think I have a lip liner for like Milani and stuff. I don't know. I'm not one to buy lip liners, but these have definitely intrigued me, and I needed like a pinky peach nude one. Next I got is the Wet n Wild waterproof liquid eyeliner, and this is in 879 black. I honestly just wanted to get a liquid liner. I'm just trying out some different liquid liners right now. I never do wings on my channel. Very rarely will I ever do a wing. I'm not good at wings personally, so therefore I don't really like to do them. And I don't know, I just like eye looks on my eyes, which is eyelashes or mascara and eyeshadow. I'm not one to do a dramatic wing. Sometimes I will, and I am practicing that way I can do them when I do dramatic looks, you know, around like end of the year with like Christmas and New Year's, anything like that. But that's kind of like the main reason. Next thing I have right here is a single shadow from Rimmel. I don't know if they're selling these everywhere, but my Walmart did have them. It is the Rimmel London Magnificent Eyes, and this is an 03 all about that base. I love the packaging. I think the packaging is real cute, but this is like that kind of like brownie transition shade. It's honestly a really, really creamy shadow. It's not the best, you know, pigmentation. It is right there. It's a little chalky. It's a little not powdery, but it definitely doesn't go on like completely smooth. But I figured for a transition shade or something like that, this would be perfect. It's just, you know, just one of those weird little random things I wanted to try. And they had another eyeshadow I wanted to try that was more of like a inner corner highlight, and the one that they had is broken, so I just ended up getting this one. But if this one's good, I definitely want to try some of the other ones. Like I said, I haven't seen it anywhere else except my Walmart. Then I got the Wet n Wild lipstick in Bare It All, because I believe this is a dupe for Velvet Teddy. I do own Velvet Teddy, and I wanted to see for myself if it was a dupe, because I really, really like that lipstick. But I don't know, I just don't really wear MAC lipsticks that much. Just, I don't know, I feel like when I first started my channel, really got into makeup, I was like, oh my God, MAC. Like, MAC is the best thing in the whole entire world. And now that I know so much more, and I always feel like I always say this in videos when I'm like reminiscing on like makeup things. But, you know, MAC's not the only great thing out there. There are other brands besides MAC, and I do realize that now. And, yeah, this is a dupe, and obviously I would wear this. It's cruelty-free for starters, and it's a lot more affordable. Next thing we have in here, this is the e.l.f. Beautifully Bare Liquid Highlighter with Vitamin E, and this is in the shade Illuminating. This is the only shade they have, and I got this because I saw someone swatch this. I don't remember where I saw it from. I honestly don't remember the channel or if it was on Instagram, but I have to swatch this because it is gorgeous. Absolutely gorgeous. I have a highlight obsession. My highlight drawer is like
overflowing, honestly.
So it did separate a little in the squeezy tube, so I tried mixing it together, but this isn't the best swatch. But look how reflective that is when it catches the light. I mean, that is gorgeous. I believe this is around $3, and once I get it all mixed up and everything like that, it'll definitely look a lot better. Just have to sit here and shake it, but I probably will use this in I don't know, probably another testing new makeup products video. I want to do a full face of e.l.f. I finally have all the products to do that, so I definitely want to do that soon. So I don't know which highlight I'm going to use though, because I have a lot of highlights from e.l.f. that I really enjoy. Last thing from e.l.f. I have is this Beautifully Bare Natural Glow Face Palette in Fresh and Flawless. I love these to travel sometimes, and I honestly love the packaging. It reminds me a lot of Hourglass with the pretty mirrored packaging. I mean, obviously it's going to get filthy with the fingerprints, but I thought it was just gorgeous. You get a really giant mirror, and I thought these shades were just really, really pretty. You get a nice bronzer, and these do completely pop out, so you can kind of customize your own palette. You get a bronzer, two blushes, and a highlight, which I think are all really, really pretty. I mean, it's more of like a natural face palette, so definitely don't expect anything like amazing, but I definitely think they're still pretty. I definitely like the bronzer. The bronzer is the most pigmented thing, which is on here. Then you have the two blushes and you have the highlight up top. You don't want blushes to be that pigmented anyways, but I definitely like the more peachy pink shades in here. Perfect for summer. And then the bronzer is really nice. Highlight didn't really show up. Like, it's honestly like barely there. I can barely see it, but it may be different on the face. We'll just have to see, but I thought that'd be nice just to travel with. I like having little things like this to travel with because it's an all in one palette. Next little random thing I have right here is this Vaseline Heal Dry Lips Lip Therapy in Cocoa Butter. I don't know why I bought this. Apparently I wanted some chapstick, and I picked up this little thing. Normally I don't go for these like pot chapsticks just because I have nails and it's sometimes a pain. I like the little twist up chapstick sticks, but this will work. I'm curious how it is because I normally do get really, really dry lips. I don't know why, but I do, and I normally put on like a lip like mask overnight. I use the ones from Bath and Body Works. Those are like my absolute favorite ones. So we'll just have to try that one out and see. And then I did go on like a number seven buy. I only got two things because I had a coupon at Walgreens. I think I got both of these for like $12 or something like that. I got the number seven Stay Perfect Foundation. This is for all skin types and the coverage is medium. I have it in Cool Vanilla. I also have the number seven Lift and Luminate Foundation, which I did a first impression review and wear test over it. And that will probably be up before this. So I will link it down below or put a card, but just get on my channel, go to videos, and you will be able to find it there. But I wanted to get this, and I think the only other foundation I'm missing now is the like airbrush one, the dropper one. But I just wanted to get this just to try it out. It has SPF 15, hyperallergenic, and it is one fluid ounce. So again, just wanted to try it really, really bad. Number seven has been my jam lately, and I don't know why. Then I have the number seven translucent perfect light loose powder. Again, I've heard great things about this powder. I love the packaging. I like how cute and just like sleek and compact it is. You get 0.7 ounces or 20 grams. So I just think it's a cute powder. I've heard amazing things, like I did say. So that's really the main reason I picked it up, and I've been on number seven kick. I don't know what it is, but I've just been on a number seven kick. All their products have impressed me. Like, I absolutely love the bronzer. It's been doing really well in my eyes. I definitely want to try like something from the whole, like something from the eyeshadows, the primers, mascara. Like, I want to try everything and do like a full face of number seven or something. Then I have this Wet n Wild Instant Flawless Complexion Highlighting and Concealing Pen. It's called Illuminati. The name's a little weird, just, you know, because the whole Illuminati thing, but it literally says Illuma and the dash and then Naughty. This is in shade Ivory Into You. So that was a tongue twister in itself. It's just one of those little pens that you can click, and you know, obviously it comes out into a little brush. You can brush it on to highlight with. I don't see this having very much coverage. I see it doing a better job as highlighting, but I thought this was cool. I believe they only sell this at, is it Walgreens I see this at, or CVS? I think it's Walgreens I see this at. So yeah, I would definitely go to Walgreens to check it out. Next thing I have right here is the L'Oreal Paris eyeshadow in 892 Amber Rush. This is one of their infallible eyeshadows. I had to get this, add this to my collection. It's a cult shade. I believe this is like a dupe for like MAC Sand, or is that even an eyeshadow? I don't even know. I've seen it in dupe videos for a MAC eyeshadow though. And it's just really pretty. I figure it's one of those nice all over lid shades. It's just really pretty. And I feel like everybody's talked about it. It's one of those cult classic eyeshadows that I needed to get it. And I'm not one to use loose eyeshadows, but I'm trying to make myself use more single eyeshadows. Last two things I have right here. This is the Flower Beauty BB Cream in BB1. My Walmart had it on clearance for $6 because they sadly got rid of most Flower Beauty products. I still have like a little display of Flower Beauty with brushes, still the powder, the Beauty Blender eyeshadow stuff, like blushes, but they don't carry this anymore, so they have it on clearance. So I picked an extra one up because I love it. So now I have two BB1s and one BB2, and anytime I see it I will always pick it up because this is great stuff. I did a first impression review and wear test of this a while back, so go through my channel and find it. It's in there. And that video did get a lot of views also. That I mean, I absolutely adored that BB cream. Like, this is the best drugstore BB cream I've ever used. But yeah, just go check it out if you want to see wear tests and all that on it, because I definitely go in like full detail. Last thing I got is the LA Girl Strobe Light Strobing Powder. This is in the shade 80 Watt. Didn't really know what color to get, so I just got this, and I honestly really really like it. It's kind of more that goldy peachy shade. I definitely want to go get more. You can't get LA Girl in Ulta. I know some Ultas do carry it, but you can't get it in my Ulta at least, or any of my Ultas in town. You can order it online, but my Sam Moon actually carries LA Girl. I don't know if everybody has Sam Moons everywhere, but I would definitely check your Sam Moon if you have one, because mine does carry LA Girl. It has a foundation, concealer, all that stuff. It doesn't have the full line, like the new blushes and everything like that, but it does have some stuff like this. So I picked this one up. If it's good, I definitely will pick up other colors, but I just wanted to get one. So I hope you guys did enjoy this video. There was a lot of stuff in there. I didn't realize there was this much stuff in there, but I'm at 20 minutes right now on my viewfinder. So hopefully I can edit it down to like under 15, or, you know, somewhere around that area. But keep an eye out for these products and testing new makeup videos, wear tests, first impressions, chit chat, get ready with me's. I mean, it's gonna be a lot of stuff in there. So I hope you guys did enjoy. I will link all the products standing down below if I can find them. I hope you guys did enjoy this video. Please subscribe. Thank you so much for watching. I will see you guys later. Bye, y'all.